our galaxy. The Milky Way, just one galaxy in our known universe. 100,000 light years wide. 200,000 million stars inside. And at least, as many planets. Welcome to my channel. Beyond Horizons. Welcome to Beyond Horizons. I'm going to tell you a story. I have a close friend in real life with, he suffered bad cancer about 2 years ago. A couple of months ago we went for dinner, we spoke about his illness. He told me something amazing that happens to him, get ready to listen. My friend had to be operated for the extraction of a tumor that was killing him. Somehow he knew something was going to happen to him. Before entering the operations room, he said goodbye to his brother and told him that he was very tired and that he would not be able to recover. During the operation, things got complicated, to the point of heart failure and brain death. My friend tells me that at that time, he felt himself very well. In a very deep the darkness, but had no fear, everything was peace and tranquility. He felt other presences around him but could not see them at 100%. Suddenly someone in a black hood stood by him. He was trying to see his face once and again, but he just could not. They start walking side by side like in a kind of China wall with roads going down left and right. He was trying to look down from where he could hear millions of people suffering, screaming and dying in a horrible cry, while he was keep on walking side to side to that mysterious being in a black hood. After a while, he began to see more and more light. A light indescribably beautiful. A light full of an impossible love to describe. A light that filled him and hugged him, making him feel part of that same light. He came to a place where there was a kind of door. There was someone there who prevented him from entering. He was told it was not his time, he had to return. My friend was very angry, began to argue, did not want to return, but he was still denied entry. He was told that the cancer he suffered was a punishment received by something that he had done wrong. Something he had done to someone, return was a must for him, to be a good human being, and he would live many years on Earth if he retrained. Next thing he remembers, is to be back in the operation room with the doctors screaming his name. As you know, I have always been more scientific than believer. But the universe is something we don't know and maybe we never get to understand. Maybe our brain isn't designed for it. We've all heard this kind of story one way or the other. But living this first-person experience with such a close friend, my curiosity has made me investigate. And there are really many studies done by university students and doctors. To my surprise, The scientists are astonished. There seems to be something else, and that death is simply a transition to another state and dimension. Something seems to survive beyond physical death. Some speculate that consciousness does not even inhabit our brains. That rather our brain is a receiver and transmitter of something that is beyond. This is not crazy. We use devices that interact with information and data hosted in a cloud. Even the most skeptical doctors to admit that there is something more after the physical death. Recently, a team of neurologists from a hospital in Berlin have discovered a strange anomaly in patients who were in terminal phase at the gates of death. What they did was to monitor 9 people who were about to die. And they decided to examine the neural brain activity carefully to see if something unusual happened. Then the answer was a yes, but it was not what they expected to happen. They detected what they defined as a cerebral tsunami. Neurons still had a hyperactivity even up to 5 minutes after death. Neurologists have no response to these facts. How it is possible that the brain gets in that state just after cardiac failure and death of the patient? Is that the moment when the brain finishes sending the consciousness of the being somewhere else? The mystery of death is equal to the mystery of life. We don't understand what we are, where we come from, and where we're going. Thousands of patients, of all countries, of all religions, of all social classes have been interviewed after having a near-death experience, and most of them coincide. It has been speculated on the drugs that patients receive in terminal phase, but if there is no activity, it is simply impossible. There are thousands of cases without explanation possible. There are thousands of cases without explanation possible, blind people who describe the doctors who attended them as they were dressed up towards each one, who were talking while trying to revive them. Other people describe facts without explanation, like seeing the hospital from the air and see that there is a red shoe on the roof and immediately a medical auxiliary up and find that shoe. Children who know nothing and describe the same type of experience, the evidence is a lot.
We're free.